Welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Richard, and today I have Pablo from Love Bonito with us. So Pablo, could you tell us what Love Bonito does?
So Love Bonito is the largest omni-channel brand in the region for women in fashion. But we also have presence in Australia and US.
Okay, so on the board itself, we have different components and services that are being presented here. So could you tell us your use case and also walk us through the architecture diagram for us, please?
So our web application, our e-commerce, is actually powered by Magento itself. Magento is an e-commerce platform. This architecture is adapted to make Magento on the best way possible. So in our case, all the users are going straight to CloudFront. And then we are going to use Varnish in EC2 in order to cache all the content, or as much as possible, from Magento itself. Then the traffic is going to be forward to EKS, Elastic Kubernetes Service, right? From Elastic Kubernetes Service, we are going to host all our Magento applications, but other services as well. Those images, those Docker images, are going to be pulled from ECR, Elastic Container Registry.
Okay, so how about the Aurora and Elastic Cache? What roles do they play in this architecture with Magento?
Right, so Aurora MySQL has actually all our business data. We have a read replica there with a multi-AC that allow us to contain all the information that the business requires. Elastic Cache, for the other side, we are using Redis, and we are caching as much as possible the content from MySQL in Elastic Cache using Redis.
Okay, so with that being said, I see S3 on the left corner of the diagram left out. So what role does S3 play in delivering this application?
Right, when we started migrating this application, the current version at the moment for Magento wasn't supporting natively S3 as a service. So we are actually using a service called S3 Fuse to mount inside of our instances, a S3 bucket. So on this case, we are going to have, as a part of the file system, a S3 bucket.
Okay, this sounds really innovative. So with this, S3 being mounted as your file system, what values does it bring for you in delivering contents to end customers?
So all the content that is going to S3 is going to be actually forwarded or provided by CloudFront, right, itself. This is going to make it faster for the user all around the world on the different areas that we are providing service, getting the content as fast as possible.
Okay, that sounds really interesting. So right now, I think Elastic Kubernetes Service is something that it stands out the most. So what were your design choices that you made in moving your Magento application to Elastic Kubernetes Service, and what were the benefits from that?
Right, on the previous platform, we couldn't actually deploy as often as we want, and we couldn't deploy without having downtime on our website. When we started exploring different ways to set up the new architecture, we realized that with our small team, the best way to do it is using Kubernetes, but also to do all the rest of the configurations regarding services, setting up the rules for auto-scaling was a lot better using Kubernetes. That's why we decide to use Kubernetes. For the other side, we are using Magento, but Magento can actually be split on three different parts. Magento itself is a monolithic application, but at the end of the day, you can split between cron jobs, the admin panel, and the web application itself. In our case, we can put specific rules for the web applications for auto-scaling. We can put a specific hardware for the admin panel that is not the same for the web application.
Okay, so as part of the benefit from what you have shared with us previously, you had a successful sales that were ran off from this architecture. So could you tell us a bit more about that?
Right, so after we did the migration, the business will start realizing that whenever we have a sale, doesn't mean that we are going to have a downtime, because now we can adapt the traffic for the different sales and for the different amount of operations that we are going to have on the business.
All right. So with the successful migrations and lessons learned from migrating your workload, what would be your next steps for this architecture and the journey with us?
Right. So the architecture is going to shape a bit on the future because we are going to roll out a headless application, removing the Magento web application part, but also creating a set of different Node.js APIs to support the headless part as well.
All right, that's really interesting. Thank you for your time, Pablo. It's really appreciated. And thank you, everyone, for joining us today. This is My Architecture. Hope to see you again soon.